Welcome to Biz Filings Expert Insights.
Hi, I'm Greg Corumbus. Our guest this week on Expert Insights is Sandra Feldman. She is a publications attorney at CT Corporation. Sandra joins us today to discuss the important differences between the sole proprietorship and legally registered, solely owned entities like a limited liability company or corporation. These are differences that business owners will want to understand clearly before choosing their business structure. So today's podcast is going to be very helpful. And Sandra, welcome back. Thanks very much for being here.
Well, thank you for having me, Greg. Now, some listeners may remember that in past podcasts, I've mentioned that one of the most important decisions for any man or woman who wants to start a small business or who has started one is whether to operate the business as a sole proprietorship or to form an LLC or corporation. And I've suspected that this is a decision they've struggled with. And I've suspected that a podcast on the distinctions between a sole proprietorship and LLCs and corporations might be a good idea.
I understand there's a new survey we conducted that confirmed those suspicions.
That's right. Biz Filings recently conducted a survey of almost 600 current and future small business owners, and the results really shed a light on their motivations in starting their small business and their fears and concerns in doing so.
Well, what did the survey show?
It makes for some interesting reading, I must say. For example, it shows that wanting to be their own boss and having the freedom to put their ideas to work are the most frequently cited reasons for starting a business, while being afraid of making a mistake and not having anyone to advise them are among the most frequently cited fears and concerns. But the result of the survey that I found the most interesting is that it showed that deciding whether to operate as a sole proprietorship or form a legal entity like an LLC or corporation is at the top of the minds of most of the survey respondents. And that's the issue that I would like to address.
Well, let's begin by defining what a sole proprietorship is, just so everybody knows, and there might be some listeners who don't, and talk about what it is and how it's different from other business structures like LLCs and corporations.
Well, a sole proprietorship, quite simply, is a business owned by one individual. And it's different from an LLC and a corporation in two main ways. First, a sole proprietorship is not a statutory entity, while LLCs and corporations are. And secondly, a sole proprietorship doesn't have an existence separate from its owners, while LLCs and corporations do.
Well, that's pretty simple. What does it mean that a sole proprietorship, though, is not a statutory entity while LLCs and corporations are?
It means, first of all, that you don't need a statute saying you can form a sole proprietorship. All you have to do is start doing business, and voila, you have a sole proprietorship. But the same isn't true of either an LLC or a corporation. There has to be a state statute saying you can form an LLC or a corporation, and you have to do whatever that statute says you have to do to form that LLC or corporation, which at a minimum will be filing a formation document with the state agency in charge of business entities. It also means that a sole proprietorship doesn't have to comply with the provisions of a governing sole proprietorship statute because there isn't one. While on the other hand, LLCs and corporations, once they're formed, have to comply with the LLC or corporation statute under which it was formed, which will mean, among other things, it'll have to maintain a registered agent and file an annual report.
Sandra, it sounds like not being a statutory entity is an advantage of the sole proprietorship. Would you agree with that?
Well, it's both an advantage and a disadvantage. It's an advantage for the small business owner in that it makes doing business as a sole proprietorship simpler. You don't have to decide which statutory entity to choose, or choose a formation state, or decide who your registered agent should be, or decide if you want your LLC or corporation to pay taxes on its profits, or if you want to pay the taxes yourself. And we know from the Biz Filing survey that small business owners already have enough to think about. Also, not being a statutory entity can make a sole proprietorship less expensive. You don't have those initial formation fees or any annual fees to maintain good standing that LLCs and corporations have.
All right, so that's the upside of being a sole proprietor. Let's flip it around now. What's the advantage of forming a statutory entity like an LLC or corporation?
Well, there's a big advantage to it. And it actually has to do with the second main distinction between a sole proprietorship and either an LLC or a corporation, and that's the separation between owner and entity. And what I mean by that is that a sole proprietorship doesn't have its own independent existence. Legally, there is no difference between the sole proprietorship and its owner, the sole proprietor. But both LLCs and corporations have their own existence. They're like artificial persons in that way. And there's a separation between an LLC and its owner, called a member, and a corporation and its owner, called, of course, a shareholder.
And this is a critical point. Explain why a separation between owner and entity is important.
Well, it's important because it results in limited liability for the sole member of an LLC and the sole shareholder of a corporation that a sole proprietor doesn't have. In a sole proprietorship, the sole proprietor owns the business and therefore is liable for all of the business's debts, obligations, and other liabilities. If, for example, there's a breach of a commercial contract or noncompliance with business licensing or tax laws or any other statute that has penalties, the sole proprietor's personal assets, like a bank account or a house, can be reached to pay the debt or penalty.
And that's not the case with an LLC or corporation, right?
That's right. If you form an LLC or a corporation, it will be that LLC or corporation that owns the business and will be responsible for the business's debts, obligations, and liabilities. And neither members nor shareholders are personally liable. And the fact that LLCs and corporations have their own existence and that members and shareholders have limited liability exists only because that's provided for in the LLC and corporation statutes, which is why I say being a statutory entity can be an advantage.
All right, let's talk about everybody's favorite topic, and that's taxes. So what about taxation and entities? Isn't that something small business owners need to consider in deciding how to structure?
Well, according to the BIS filing survey, taxation is definitely something they're concerned with, and it should be a consideration because sole proprietorships, solely owned corporations, and solely owned LLCs are all subject to different tax rules for federal income tax purposes.
Well, I'm sure it's a complex subject. The tax code usually is, but can you briefly discuss the differences?
Well, sure, it is complex, but to put it in simple terms, in the case of a sole proprietorship, the IRS makes no distinction between the sole proprietorship and the sole proprietor. The business's profits are the sole proprietor's profits, and he or she pays the taxes on those profits. In the case of a corporation, a sole shareholder has a choice. By default, the corporation will pay income taxes on the profits. We call that C corporation taxation because the tax rules are found in subchapter C of the Internal Revenue Code. However, by making a filing with the IRS, the shareholder can elect to pay the income tax on the profits him or herself, and we call that S corporation taxation, so named because the tax rules are found in subchapter S of the Internal Revenue Code.
What about an LLC?
Well, the sole member of an LLC actually has three choices. The default rule is that the LLC will be taxed exactly the same as a sole proprietorship. However, by making the appropriate filings with the IRS, the LLC can be taxed the same as an S corporation or a C corporation.
So we're talking with Sandra Feldman, publications attorney at CT Corporation. And Sandra, we've outlined a lot of different things here. And so there are clear differences between sole proprietorships and separately formed entities like LLCs or corporations, whether it's in regards to their complexity, limited liability, and taxation. So is one choice better than the other for most small business owners?
It really depends upon each unique situation, and there are a lot of factors to consider. Like the type of business. Is it one with a high risk of liability? Or the owner's financial situation? Will he or she need outside funding, which is easier to get for a corporation or an LLC? Or are there plans to expand? And what's the exit strategy? Selling the business or leaving it to his or her children? And those are just some of the factors. So for many small business owners, getting the advice of legal and tax professionals is probably a good idea. And using a corporate service company like CT to help with the compliance needs, regardless of the business structure, can also help relieve some of the pressure small business owners have. That's really the best recommendation I can make.
Sandra, we'll have to call time there. Thanks as always for being with us and explaining these important distinctions for our listeners.
Thank you, Greg.
Sandra Feldman is publications attorney for CT Corporation. I'm Greg Corumbus reporting for Expert Insights. For more information, please visit bizfilings.com.
Biz Filings, a Wolters Kluwer company, has been incorporating businesses since 1996.